Hello everyone, your favorite Senso Tech Jedi, Lisa here with number one in this classroom management series or playlist that we are creating to help train teachers on how to utilize the tools within their Senso portal. So how we have set this up is the playlist can be auto-played, so you can just go 1, 2, 3, 4 all the way through all of these videos all at once, or you can click around and just kind of learn at your own speed, or if you're looking for a specific tool to learn about. Just look at the thumbnails on each of the pictures and it will have a title of what I'm going to talk about in each one of these videos. For number one, I'm going to simply talk about how to log into the portal and some of the areas within your portal. So let's go ahead and do that now. To get to your portal in a browser, you would go to portal, portal.senso.cloud. And when you have put that in, you're going to see this splash screen here. Now you have several different ways to log in to your customized portal account. If you received an email from your tech director, organizational admin, whomever is in charge of the admin side of your portal, you may have changed your password using that link. You can still have that changed here and still single sign on with your Microsoft, Google, or Clever account. So don't worry, it will take you to the same place. So single sign on, so much easier in that if you already have a school account with Microsoft, Google, or Clever, you can simply click on one of these like I'm doing right now with Google and choose your account and it will automatically or auto-magically sign you in. So let's talk about the portal just for a moment. It may look a little different on yours. Again, these are portals that can be customized. So this is what my teacher portal looks like. I have my group area with my Google Classroom and some groups that I've been given access to. This is my list view and thumbnail view area for the devices that I have also been given access to monitor and manage. And then up here is this set of tools that again have been set for me as my classroom management tools. So don't worry if your portal looks a little different or if there's some tools or things you may have up here that we don't go over. They will be in other series playlists and you can find them pretty easy. Up here at the top, again, just some general information, your login name, if you have the ability to live chat with support, that's going to be here. Again, this can be removed. This takes you to our knowledge base articles. You may not have access to this admin center either, so don't worry if that's not there, it's okay. Messages, these are messages from us to our customers. So look for that if you have a little icon there, that's going to be things we're sending out because we want to talk to you about it. Okay, so that is it for number one in this playlist series. I'm gonna go ahead and end this one, and then just if you want, follow me right on over to number two. I'll see you there.